In the San Francisco Bay Area Peninsula, on the edge of Silicon Valley, you'll find the town of Redwood City, California, home to Sequoia High School. Right off the center of town, the Spanish Colonial Revival style campus has seen a lot of modernization over the years. Most recently, the school library underwent a complete rebranding as a media center with a complete renovation. The classic building, modeled after Stanford University and an original feeder school, is steeped in tradition. Don't step on the seal. Sequoia High School is home to the Interbaccalaureate program, known as IB, two renowned academies, one the Digital Arts Academy and the other a Health Career Academy, as well as many other enriching activities. Let's go inside to see what it looks like today on our way to the new media center. As you walk in, you'll see we have some cheerful students greeting us as a way to welcome us into the community and place of friends. It's worth noting that the school's deep traditions and history are often controversial. Our demographics seen here represent the surrounding community. How does that affect the Library Media Center? We strive to provide opportunities to everyone, and students would come to the Media Center for various reasons, from checking out books, to borrowing gear, to learning something new, or to just practice mindfulness. I'm Betsy Snow, and I'm happy to show off our brand new space. Upon entering, you'll see a portrait project that was a favorite collaboration of mine with the digital photography teacher, Miss Sheehan. Students see themselves upon entering the space. We ask that students sign in at one of three iPad terminals so that we can account for their presence during their unscheduled periods. We also like to be sure that students feel comfortable, and so we feature their art as much as we can. Here is a book art piece that was recently completed along with those stars. We keep our printing terminals easily accessible on the edge of our tea garden or our learning commons outside. Students come in and can take care of business quickly and without distraction due to the customized dock. Here's what it might look like when they use their QR code to access the virtual learning commons. On the virtual learning commons are links to everything students would need related to the Media Center, including research tutorials and all of the information that I relay through the Media Center. In the far area of the classroom space, you'll see students on their unscheduled period. Just last week, we hosted our first author visit. Our brand new media lab will hopefully inspire students to take their dreams to the next level. Here's an example of a Photoshop lesson I did with our ELD students who were able to express themselves through art and imagery using industry standard projects. The media lab was designed with smaller classes in mind, and students can come work individually on multimedia collaborations. Sometimes I just have to be available for whatever students may need, whether they want help with their extended essay in the IB program, or if they just want some digital support or help finding a book. I am in charge of all of the signage and displays, so I do a lot of work to make sure that students feel comfortable and that they have what they need at their fingertips in our space. It's exciting to see students choose to come to the Media Center and colleagues as well. Mr. Dodge here, the drone pilot, was excited to come in and help show off this new wonderful space. This is the Fireside Room, and it's with the help of our new Sequoia Media Center ambassadors that we were able to put together the Evolution of Technology Museum and Special Collection. As the original footprint of the library, I feel it's important for students to see what comes before them. So I designed the space to have windowed drawers so students can see history and relics from our past. Here is the commencement from 1919. The idea of the technology evolution counter stemmed from students' questions and understanding of how typewriters worked, what we did before we had calculators, and before we had Siri. And so with the community's help, using nextdoor.com, I've been able to acquire different items that show a true evolution of technology. You'll see we've kept beautiful books lining the backdrop to remind students of how treasured our books have been over the years. Otherwise, we include some of these old items so that students might feel inspired to learn more. We are also keeping a digital terminal here so that students can look back at the archived Sequoia Times newspapers to see what happened in history. This is an example of how I help students use different features of technology to create digital projects. Using Google Street View, I show them how I can create this 3D VR ready piece, and that they might do the same when they are doing a project in their history class or in our EL class. They might do a tour of their neighborhood, etc. Regarding our budget, it's important to be sure that messaging is clear about what we include in our space. Our Sequoia High School Education Foundation, along with our PTSA mini grants, have allowed me to keep subscriptions active to JSTOR, ArtStore. I'm able to add titles to our Gale Virtual Reference Library, and I hope to start purchasing book titles in bundles where we get an audio copy, an e-copy, and a hard copy moving forward. My assessment plans include various forms like making the most of the media center and outreach using S'more newsletter, where I can keep track of user interaction. This, coupled with traditional assessment methods, keeps us moving in the right direction to being future ready. Being future ready means that in addition to having displays that engage students with books and different media types, we're also thinking ahead, making sure that this beautiful remodel can support the vision of the students. It's really important as a leader in literacy to be sure that people know that our priority is engaging students and helping them succeed and become critical thinkers.
We've started to genrefy our collection a little bit, which means we've pulled out sections that we know are of high interest to our students. So right here, this whole cutout is dedicated to graphic novels. New Media Center.
Look at all of those circles. You'll just represent endless learning. Thank you.
What are you thinking, Josh?
This is amazing. It's like taking a step into like tomorrow.
Can you remember where you used to come visit me? It was probably
right here.
It was right here, but yet now.
Right,
and now we can talk without barriers, and we can.
The books are everywhere.
Easy.
At our access.
Yep, you don't have to go into the back for the fiction.
Wow, that's amazing.
Okay, we'll go take a look around and see what you like. See you later, Josh. Great.
This is so exciting.
Isn't it? I'm so glad that you're excited, because I'm excited. All right, what do you think of the new media center?
It's great, and there's so much space, and it actually prompts people to come in.
Oh, good. Warren, what do you think? Hey, Ruth, what do you think?
Aaliyah,
what do you think?
It.
You guys like
I
it?
I love it.
I'm glad we're seniors.
It's a whole new world out here.
Yeah. Well, you're welcome anytime. Just because you're seniors and because you graduate doesn't mean you can't come back. What do you think?
This is so beautiful. I love this. I'm blown away.
Okay, good. Go look around and then come back and let me know.
I don't want to ruin your video.
What do you think?
Here's the printing.
Oh, it's down there below the.
I love it.
Okay, good.